Thank you, Abdul Karim Sengendo. Now, as COVID-19 cases continue to rise in Hoima, the Ministry of Health Policy on Home-Based Care is providing a challenge in the fight against the pandemic. Dr. Lawrence Tumusime, the Hoima District Health Officer, says that the biggest number of COVID-19 people is being managed from their homes, and this is risky as it exposes more people to the virus. Ismail Kasoha reported.
Since I'm suffered and recovered, no more what? No more mass.
Dr. Tumusime says that some villages in Chitoba and Chabigambire sub-counties have resorted to isolating and banning families who have either lost anybody or have a positive patient from accessing public goods such as water sources, shops, and even blocked their roads to prevent them from leaving their homes. That has led to stigma.
There's a stigma that has been put with home-based care. Especially we have noted some cases in a few sub-counties like Kitawa here, where we had a family almost cut off and blocked from leaving their home because they had somebody who died in that family because of COVID-19. We also have some other family in Chabigambire where we also had issue. Again, the family was condemned from leaving home, not accessing the well, and so on.
Dr. Tumusime says that the other challenge is with people admitted to home-based care who have decided to roam around town and even go to congested areas such as markets, which contravene the guidelines of COVID-19.
Clients whom we expect to be isolated at home, sometimes as you're moving around the streets, you see them moving. As you're moving around the market, you see also them in the market buying things. That is a big challenge because we stand a risk of having that spread.
Meanwhile, the doctor says that they have decided to integrate COVID-19 with the fight against other diseases such as HIV/AIDS so that the situation doesn't run out of hand for other diseases.
A lot of efforts have been directed there. Our daily programmings, the routine programmings have been changed. And we, of course, have a risk if we do not integrate our services of getting our HIV preventive and care guidelines and then activities as well as services. We are currently advocating for the integration for those services, whereby even in the messaging that we give, as we mentioned the prevention of COVID-19, we should be able to mention the prevention of HIV.
He says working with partners, they have adjusted the schedule for drug distribution for HIV positive patients to cater for the prevailing challenges.
And we have established specific teams, specific members at the facilities, at least two per facility, to be able to distribute these vaccines, these medicines to the community, to the clients. And we're also shifting away from the clients who have been having monthly refills. We are trying to give them the multi-month refills, at least 3 months, as we keep on monitoring them on phone calls and also getting in touch with them as well on phone calls to ensure that they are adhering and any of their concerns, health concerns, are addressed.
Story by Ismail Kasioha for the news in Hoima City.